A very warm welcome to a brand new episode of Parliamentary Debates. I am Smriti Rastogi. In this program, we will inform you about various important debates in the Upper House. In order to effectively implement the Right to Education Act, Rajya Sabha debated on Right of Children to Free and Compulsory Education Amendment Bill 2017. Today, we bring to you the second of the five-part series of the debate on the issue held on 1st of August 2017.
Respected Deputy Chairman, sir, I thank you very much for allowing me to participate in an important bill concerning the future of the millions of students of our country. The objectives of the bill are to provide opportunity to untrained and unqualified teachers, appointed, acquire such minimum qualification. It is a very fitting to note that out of the total number of 66.41 lakhs, teachers at the elementary level, 11 lakhs are still untrained. Better trained teacher would mean an improvement in the learning outcomes of children. It is said that just knowing a subject or being a graduate is not sufficient qualification to become an elementary school teacher. One has to be trained in the understanding the learning process of children, their diversity, and one has to develop necessary teaching skill under trained supervision. The government's budget for the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan has increased from ₹12,825 crore in 2009 to 2010 to ₹22,500 crore in 2016 and 17. Around 3.5 lakhs schools have been opened in the last one decade, and 99% of the Indian rural population now has a primary school within the 1 kilometer radius. India has the largest number of out-of-school children in the world. Sir, school education for children aged between 6 and 14 years in the fundamental rights of India. However, from 2010, after the Act was passed, it has faced severe challenges in the proper implementation. Even the budget allocation for the year 2017 and 18 has been very disappointing for the education sector. The low increase in the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan by 1,000 crore is not going to help in any way to implement the RTE Act meaningfully. Even after 6 years, the implementation of RTE Act, only 9.5% schools have been made RTE compliant across the country. It has been established that millions of children are still out of school, and the thousands of additional schools are yet to be built, while lakhs of teachers are yet to be recruited and trained. Low allocation is hampering the quality of education in government schools, which have teachers' vacancy of more than 5 lakhs. 10% of the schools are single teacher, 30% of the school are without functioning toilet for girls, and 20% of it still lack safe drinking water. Now, I come to some issue faced by the people in rural area where schools are not there within a kilometer radius as per the RTE Act. The schools in private sector were not willing to accommodate the students from below poverty line, and even if they provide admission, they insist the students to pay the entire amount of fee at one time, alleging that there is a long delay in releasing fund under RTE Act to these schools. Our state government has been implementing the Section 12(1)(c) of the Act is true letter and spirit for the admissions made in private schools in 2013 and 14, and 2014 and 15, a reimbursement of 97.05 crores has already been made to private schools by the state government, and this amount was claimed in the year in the 2006 and 2007 under the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan plan. An amount of 18 lakhs has been approved by the government for reimbursement. Despite non-release of fund by the government of India, the state government continued implementation of Act in the year 2015 and 16 and 2016 and 17, and additionally 1,92,370 number of children has been admitted in private schools under the 25% reservation. The private schools would have to be reimbursed an amount of ₹310.70 crores for the children admitted for the year 2015 and 16 and 2016 and 17, and the state government would have to be reimbursed a total amount of 407.75 crore for 328,910 children under SSA. The government, under the dynamic leadership power Amma had, ensured the growth of education in the state by providing the all grants and tools for the students, from books to laptop and free school bus passes to bicycle, and these initiatives were led to a drastic reductions in the dropout of school children. At the end of my speech, I would like to urge the government to release the total grant under SSA of 1,340.89 crore and sum of rupees 45.05 crore under RMSA for the year 2016 and 2017, and to link again the model school program with RMSA to de-linking with affect the children who are already enrolled in the model schools, and also release the fund claimed by the state government of Tamil Nadu for the free and post-matric scholarships, so as to motivate the people belongs to the downtrodden communities, as demanded by our Honorable Chief Minister Thiru Edappadi Palaniswami. With this, I conclude and support the bill. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The next speaker is Derek O'Brien.
Sir, basically, in one sentence, what is this bill? It's giving a longer time for teachers to be trained. So 2015, it's taken retrospectively. So 4 years to that, it takes it up to 2019. I would have been happier standing here today in 2015 if the minister had brought this bill in 2015, allowed for 4 years, it would have given a better chance. I hope we don't have to come back here in 2019 to again bring an amendment to this bill to ask for it another 2 years. The second option obviously could be is that you leave that option to the state governments. I think ideation, implementation, where we have all failed, we have collectively failed. As parliamentarians, as parents, as teachers, as educationists, we have all failed. We've had a bill. Now let's focus where we haven't implemented the bill very well. Sir, because if we had implemented the bill well, today, if you look at it, the survey which has been done, a class 5 student is actually the level of a class 2 student. 3 out of 5 students in the third standard, sir, they can't do a basic subtraction. 4 out of 5 students, sir, can't do division. So these are a collective failure. Now the issue here, sir, is the teachers. In my state, in West Bengal, this extra time which the minister is giving, we've been very proactive with this. We've appointed 80,000 teachers in the last 6 years, 50,000 about in the primary, and about 28,000 in the secondary. So things are going well there, sir. 1976, this is an important year, because till 1976, education was a state subject. It was only in 1976, you come to your own conclusions, that it was put onto the concurrent list. Let's take a view, for example, on detention policy. My state's policy is very, very clear. We've written to the minister. We do not believe in automatic promotion. We don't mean to deprive anybody, but our honest suggestion is that if that does not mean we will deprive the students. If the boys or girls are getting detained, we have to have special classes, we have to give them special inputs, and then bring them up to the level. Sir, I would like to thank the minister for clarifying one thing. NCRT books will be compulsory in the CBSE curriculum. Now that is again impeding on state rights, but the minister did clarify, and I have no issues with that, sir. Sir, in fact, these exam boards, be it the NEET, where they made a complete mess of, the CBSE made a complete mess of the NEET, or now, at least till 2 days ago, I was hearing the ICSE board were trying to give examinations for class 5 students and class 8 students. Sir, this again goes against the basic principles of this Act, because section 30 of this Act clearly states that you cannot have children class 5 to 8. So this is where the states have a role to play. Sir, Vinayji said quite correctly, the minority schools, quite correctly and rightly, have been kept away. Sir, we call them minority schools, but actually they are the majority schools. They may be run by a minority community, say the Christian schools. But the most of the boys and girls who go there, including so many of us in this house, have received a majority education. I want to dwell a little, sir, on the private schools. Not to make a point for the private schools, but this is where I firmly believe, passionately believe, that to make this work, we have to make it work together. First suggestion, what happens in a school where you say 25%, I've got 400 students in class 1, so 100 have to be as per RTE. Now, those and 300 regular, 100 students when they are not taken, sir, what will you do? Private schools have to take this up as a responsibility. The private schools have to look at this as a corporate social responsibility. They have to go out and look for students. Just putting up a notice in school saying, wagera, 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 25% is reserved, oh no. I suggest very humbly to the private schools to please go out proactively and look for students. So the third point, there are local officers today, and I say this with responsibility, who are giving certificates, having children admitted into the schools, and then taking flush money from the bank. Sir, not acceptable. The fourth point, sir, is uniforms. Again, I appeal to the private schools. If you're taking these students, I know the Act says they don't need uniforms, but once they don't have uniforms, they stand out. I don't expect them to pay for the uniforms. I appeal to the private schools to please pay for those uniforms. Make them look like the rest of you. Sir, and the last point is the more serious point, and I don't think we're going to finish it here in a discussion. There are serious social, psychological issues of getting boys and girls from different economic backgrounds to sit together in a school. I don't have the answer, but I think we need to seriously discuss this, debate this, and not win any political points, because at the end of it all, sir, for this right to education to be successful, doesn't matter whether you're sitting this side or this side, and I know this government loves using acronyms, different acronyms, so I've got one for them today, sir, as I end. We need to do STEP, S-T-E-P-P. S, the schools have a role to play. T, the teachers have a role to play. E, the educationists or the maliks of the schools have a role to play. And P is a double P. Parliament has a role to play, and parents have a role to play. And I would appeal to the minister, if you can get these 5 stakeholders on board, we can change the lives of the children of India. Thank you, sir.
Sir, if you go around the parliament within the radius of 5 to 10 kilometers, sir, you will find children of this age only, dozens of children, sir, working as labourers, as workers, especially in edible outlets, sir. When you ask those kids, ki yaar bache tum batao tumhara umar kya hai, main tumhe free education dene ke liye taiyar hoon. Will you come with me? I'll help you to study, to move forward in life. Sir, they are so beautifully taught that they immediately say, sir, my age is 15, 17 or 18, sir, or above that. They don't hesitate saying a lie, sir.
अमीर खुसरो देहलवी, सूफी संगीतज्ञ और शायर, हिंदी खड़ी बोली के पहले लोकप्रिय कवि, कव्वाली के जन्मदाता, उत्तर प्रदेश के पटियाली में जन्मे खुसरो हिंदी के अलावा फारसी में भी लिखते थे कलाम। फारसी शायरी में शेख सादी और हाफिज के समकक्ष खुसरो ने हिंदी कविता में भी खूब कमाया नाम। तबला और सितार जैसे संगीत यंत्रों का किया आविष्कार और भारतीय लोक कला को दुनिया भर में दिलाई पहचान।
श्रीमती जनदास वैद्य,
थैंक यू सर। दिस बिल इज ए कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द हिस्टोरिक लेजिस्लेशन। इन द फिनेंशियल मेमोरेंडम इट हैज बीन क्लियरली स्टेटेड दैट क्लॉज टू ऑफ द बिल प्रोवाइड्स फॉर इंसर्टेन ऑफ ए न्यू प्रोविजन ऑफ सब सेक्शन टू ऑफ सेक्शन 23 ऑफ द राइट of children to the free and compulsory education act 2009 so as to provide that every teacher appointed or in position as on 31st march 2015 who does not possess minimum qualification as laid down under subsection 1 of the said section shall acquire such minimum qualification within a period of 4 years. That is, this is the crux of this amendment bill. Sir, 66.41 lakhs elementary, 11 lakhs are untrained, 5 lakhs in government schools and 6 lakhs in private schools. They almost our got trained by 31st March 2015. The bill gives time up to 31st March, I hope that is 2021. This is their training is very important to raise quality of teaching, but many of them are SC, ST and OBCs. Government has to help them particularly, but funds allocated in 2017-18 for SSA has increased maybe rupees 1,000 crores. This will not help to improve quality of elementary education. Sir, a higher allocation of resources of school education from primary school level to secondary level was expected, but after a year of long waiting, school education has been totally neglected in the budget. Sir, literacy rate in the state of Tripura reached to 97% among the highest in the country. The female literacy rate is 95.71%. With huge expansion of school education, free textbooks, free studies up to the college level, Tripura has virtually universalized education up to secondary stage. But unfortunately, here it has become a mechanism or way of making money. It should not be considered as an industry. It should be considered as an area where you contribute. The Honorable Minister brings out this bill and we all support it, but the government should take due care of the areas such as midday meal, infrastructure issues, etc. It is not only the responsibility of the central government, but the state government should also come forward and contribute. Sir, what I have found is the government must also inform the House as to how many unqualified teachers were barred from teaching since 2015 and as to how it is ensured they do not snake into the school to teach an ad hoc basis. Therefore, my amendment is You cannot control all these things at the union government level. Allow the respective states to take decision, especially as this in the right-based law. For any change that you want to make it in the law, you have come to Parliament that you have get it sanctioned. For the right-based law, why cannot we allow the empower to the respective state governments to do this?
Yes, thank you, Madam Vaidyaji. Now, Sri Anupam Mohanty.
Thank you, sir. Sir, before speaking anything, I would like to say that my party, Biju Janata Dal, supports this bill, and we are happy that the ministry has taken a very dynamic step to build a nation, a proper nation, a strong nation. Sir, initially I would say that the right of children to free and compulsory education not only entitles to free and compulsory education, but also entitles compulsory admission, attendance, and completion of elementary, basic and elementary education, sir. So this act was passed in Parliament in 2009 and came into effect from 1st of April 2010. Sir, I just have a small question in my mind that yes, when we talk about 100% literacy in India, so why do we just think of those children between age 6 to 14? Why can't we make basic and elementary education compulsory for everyone, barring age line, sir? Why can't everyone be educated properly so that we have a proper nation, a proper strong nation which can think very strongly and very firmly towards development? Sir, I'm very sorry to say that although the government is initiating this bill, right to compulsory education for the age group of 6 to 14, but if you go around the parliament within the radius of 5 to 10 kilometers, sir, you will find children of this age only, dozens of children, sir, working as laborers, as workers, especially in edible outlets, sir. When you ask those kids, ki yaar bache tum batao tumhara umar kya hai, main tumhe free education dene ke liye taiyar hoon, will you come with me, I'll help you to study, to move forward in life, sir, they are so beautifully taught that they immediately say, sir, my age is 15, 17 or 18, sir, or above that. They don't hesitate in saying a lie, sir. Sir, I feel unless the government takes a strong stand about mandatory school attendance, about mandatory school attendance by all children below the age group of 16, maybe not 18, sir, then maybe we, the thought that we have of 100% literate India can come true, or else it will be in dreams. The other miserable approach of the government is to somehow make the children clear 8th standard for appearing in the board. This needs to be recognized, sir, as this will only increase the data of literate children in the government records with zero and minimal result of effective compulsory education. Sir, aaj kisi naukri ke liye, koi bhi chote job ke liye, koi ek ladka jab jata hai kahin par bhi, interview dene ya apply karne. So we demand the minimum criteria of educational qualification is 12th standard pass. Before it was 10, now it has come to plus 2, I mean 12th class. So why don't you think of making education compulsory for every children, free and compulsory, till 12th? Why only till the age of 14? Because usko koi naukri karne ke liye, uske jivika ko acche se banane ke liye, he has to qualify 12th class. So the government should think on that, sir, to make it compulsory for 12th standard. Sir, and also, I'm very happy to see that the analysts, when I analyze the dropout rates of students from school, the girls are beating the boys, sir. And it will be a great support for my own bill that I had introduced in the House last year, advocating the equal participation in governance by women. I'm really happy to learn this, sir. Sir, along with encouraging girl child for coming forward for education, all the policies concerning education should be made compulsory for the minority institutions also, so that the benefit and the growth is uniform. Sir, this bill deals with only one aspect, and that aspect is relating to shortage of qualified teachers. But he has picked up one aspect which has been pending for last so many years, or say at least 3 years, last 3 years, which should have been completed by 2013. So I have a question relating to this issue. Why did Honorable Minister bring this issue in 2017 and why not before that? Can the government inform this House what happened when the earlier March 31st, 2015 deadline had approached? Were those underqualified teachers banned from teaching? It has been 2 years. It has been 2 years since the deadline, and there might be some amount of churning that had happened with the education system. Did this churning force certain teachers to get trained as quickly as possible in order to retain their posts? Sir, I would second what Mr. Derek O'Brienji said, that states must be given liberty and some powers to take this forward. I would also say my Biju Janata Dal's colleague in Lok Sabha, Sri Bharthuri Mahatabji, he had brought an amendment on the same bill. Sir, in the bill, line 12, after 2017, just to add, or such extended period as may be specified by the state government by notification. Sir, it is very clear now that the union government alone cannot do this properly. So why can't the union government give some power, empower the state governments, respective state governments, to come forward and be a part in making this bill a successful one?
All right.
Sir, ek tarah hum baat, ek jagah pe hum baat karte hain to give free education, right to free and compulsory education. Aur dusri jagah pe, hum sare MPs ka sabse bada problem har saal 10 quotas milte hain central school mein bachchon ko admission dene ke liye. Ghar ke bahar, sir, jab bhi main nikalta hun, मतलब रोज 10 15 या 20 लोगों का भीड़ रहता है कि मेरे बच्चे को पढ़ाने के लिए आप मौका दे दो, कोटा आपका दे दो. बट सर, हु एम आई टू डिनाई देम फ्रॉम स्टडिंग? हु एम आई टू से देम नो? आई एम नोबडी टू से देम नो. आई हैव नो राइट टू से देम नो. सर, आई रिक्वेस्ट ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर, सर, इधर आप एक काम कीजिए. सर, एमपी होने के बाद में अच्छे काम बहुत किया हूँ, बस पर ये सिर्फ एक ही कारण है, हो सकता है जिसके वजह से मैं बदनाम भी हो जाऊंगा. सर, सो या तो आप 10 कोटा कैंसिल कर दीजिए, एक कोटा भी मत रखिए, या फिर अगर दे रहे हैं,
अगर दे रहे हैं,
गिव अस सच पावर्स सो दैट वी कैन रियली हेल्प गाइस गेटिंग एजुकेशन, प्रॉपर एजुकेशन, प्रॉपर स्कूल. सर, थैंक यू सो मच. सर,
Rajya Sabha members supported the bill aimed at ensuring free and compulsory education to children between 6 to 14 years. Members also reiterated that there will be a qualitative improvement in teaching methods if teachers are trained. In the next episode, we will continue with the remaining part of the debate on the bill. Till then, thank you for watching.